climate change is the most significant challenge of our times. We are only able to mitigate adverse climate effects if we avoid fossil CO2 emissions. One important technical solution to that are e-fuels, which are synthetic fuels produced from regenerative energy. These e-fuels do not only allow us to give new vehicles a net zero carbon footprint, but also the existing vehicles in use, which is around 1.4 billion vehicles worldwide. We need full CO2 transparency. If we are serious about climate protection in road traffic, we need to look at the CO2 emissions from well to wheel. Even an electric vehicle is only as CO2 neutral as the electricity with which it has been charged. Electrification will make an important contribution to meeting our CO2 targets, but electrification alone will not be sufficient. We will need e-fuels. This is why we advocate the broad production and use of e-fuels in road traffic. Offsetting e-fuels to the manufacturer's fleet consumption is one important example. There are voices calling for a ban of the combustion engine. However, it's a fact that even after 2030, the majority of vehicles in the world will be powered by combustion engines. E-fuels enable combustion engines to run with a net zero carbon footprint, and thus being part of the solution of a CO2 neutral mobility in the future. The CO2 neutrality of e-fuels is not factored in with regard to the fuel price right now. This is why, to the end consumer, e-fuels are still very expensive. E-fuels will only become first choice to the end customer if the legislator recognizes the CO2 neutrality, and this is also reflected in the fuel price. This is also one requisite for e-fuels to be produced in the sufficient quantities. Bosch and other companies are already using CO2 reduced fuels in their corporate fleets. So you can see all the technical issues are solved.